Hey, how's it everyone? It's the Happy Hawaiian here, Lil Dab, and welcome to the most bittersweet game of the century. Okay, maybe not of the century, but in my game. But yeah, I mean, this is the most bittersweet game I have ever played. You guys will figure it out. You guys will know towards the end of this game what I'm talking about. But as of right now, I'm going to be talking about my marriage. I just got married. I am fantastically happy. I'm like the happy married Hawaiian instead, you know what I'm saying? And some of you guys might know what marriage life is. It's maybe you guys had those moments where, you know, marriage isn't all that. Marriage is wrong. Marriage is bad. Marriage is great to some of you. But I think marriage is a work in progress. I think that marriage is great when you both work together. It's not a single man or a single woman thing. You know what I'm saying? I'm not gonna lecture you guys. I mean, this is not like marriage 101. I don't know shit about being married. I'm young, but I got married. But I'm not regretting any of this. You know, I'm not regretting the fact that I got married to my wife. I love her to death. She's great. She loves games. What more can I ask? Of course, that's not the only thing, but I mean, that is awesome. I mean, you guys gotta admit that. But yeah, I mean, marriage life is going great. You know, it makes no difference from what we were before. And I tell her that, you know, how do you feel being married, sweetheart? She tells me that there's no difference, and I noticed that, and I'm like, yeah, there is no difference between when we're married, or when we're married, or when we're just together. You know, the paperwork, you know, we're legally married now. You know, we have paperwork stating that we're a couple, I guess that's what the meaning is. But yeah, I mean, our love is true. Our love is binded between the love, and the love is binded between love. That is my quote to you guys. But yeah, I mean, this is one of the most bittersweet games. One of the longest games I think I've uploaded before. I think my first upload was like 9 minutes long. But yeah, I mean, I'm looking at this Coca-Cola can. This Coca-Cola. Ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho-ho this Coca-Cola can. I'm gonna tell you guys a short story. Me and my wife, my fiance back then, we went to a grocery store and bought a 36 case Coca-Cola. And oh, look, there I go again, Coca-Cola. And we went through it. We maybe went through about maybe 5 or 6 cans. Me and my mom did, and my wife. And it started to get a little low on Coca-Cola. And I picked up this can, and I thought, what the hell is going on here? Picked it up, and it was empty. It was not even open, and it was empty. I ranted. I cried like a little meh. But after I started to notice what this can really meant, I thought it was pretty damn cool to have an empty, non-open Coca-Cola can. Okay, one of the most known products in the world. One of the most known products in the world. And to have an empty one, not even open, I think it's going to become like a $3 billion can later, you know what I'm saying? Take it to Pawn Stars and see how much this bugger goes up for it to be, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, I'm looking at it. I'm looking at the flowers. The flowers are great. Bought my wife, what should we call it? It's like a mechanical flower. You press a button and it blooms. It blooms out and there's a message inside. But yeah, I mean, I got that from another, from a place that I'm not going to tell you guys about because this is mine. They don't sell it anywhere else, I think. Well, it was a known store anyway. Maybe. Whatever. But yeah, this is I think I get my second Reaper sometime right now. I'm not too sure. But I'm married. This is the greatest. Oh, let me tell you guys this story. I went to basic because I'm in the army. I went to basic training a long time ago, and they were starting to ask me a lot of weird questions because they think that Hawaii, we still live in grass huts, and you know, and they didn't think, you know, what we know what McDonald's is or whatnot. So I started to get fed up already, and this was like towards the end. So really all my brothers and sisters already, they started to ask me if I knew Jack in the Box, and they started to laugh and whatnot, and I was like, what is Jack in the Box? Is it a guy in a box? Let that motherfucker out! Let Jack out of the box! You know what I'm saying? You know, it's suffocating. They all started cracking up laughing because I had this serious look on my face, and you know, it was like, who's Jack? Wait, he's in a box? Let that motherfucker out! He's suffocating! But they started to roll on the floor and whatnot, and you know, I started to tell them, you know, we have all the same crap as you do, maybe even more, knowing that we're a tourist place to be. We're the most beautiful place on earth. I think we're like second or third most beautiful places to go in the world, and I think the Bermuda Triangle was the first one. The Bermuda Triangle, yeah, because that's beautiful. Beautifully, like, get disappeared and stuff and leave without being existed. But yeah, in this cutscene, I spent about a good minute and a half, 2 minutes, trying to look for a weapon. This is one of the clues to my bittersweet moment of this game. It took me a super long time just to find something. So I found this and got me a Predator missile. Started to whoosh down. Boom, killed these guys. End of the game. I'm like, yeah. 2 double kill Predator missiles. Yeah. But yeah, you see what the bittersweet moment of this video will be. Flawless Bing Bong 46-0. This is the Happy Hawaiian here. No Moab. This is the Happy Hawaiian here. Little Abu out.